The Joranalogue Compare 2 dual window comparator is a logic module that compares incoming voltages that you send it with a threshold that you define with the knobs. What makes this module unique is the window comparator aspect of it, which I'll explain in this video. It just means that you can create these really funky, slippy, vibey, rhythmical gates out of it, as well as a whole bunch of complex audio rate tones and other sounds you can get out of it as well. So I'm going to use a visual aid to help me explain what's going on in the module. The best way I think about it is that if you imagine like a scale of value, which is from minus 5 volts all the way to 5 volts, and in the middle you've got 0 volts. A window is just a range of voltage within this scale. So that, for example, you feed voltage into the window like an LFO, like that, and it compares at this point, it compares where the voltage of the incoming signal is compared to the window defined by parameters on the module. So on the module itself, it's two window comparators stuck together and it's symmetrical. So we'll just concentrate on the left side for now. And you've got the size and shift parameters here. What the size does is it increases or decreases the size of this window here. So if I turn this to the right here, the size of the window increases. So it'll be more like that. If I turn it to the left, the size of the window decreases, so it'd be more like that. The shift moves this window up and down the scale, so if at center positions the window looks something like that, when you increase the shift to the right, it moves the window upwards like here. And if you move the window, if you shift it to the left, then the window moves down the scale like that. So when you've got a, so let's say you're in center position, and your window is there, and you've got an LFO that's coming in and it's doing this. Oh my god. You've got an LFO that's coming in and it's doing that. What it's going to be doing is it's going to be at the point of the black line, it's going to be comparing the voltage of the LFO going into it against the window. You can see that this light here is white. That means that the comparator is active. And if I was to shift this here, it turns to blue. If I shift it to the left, it turns to red. What that means is that right now, 0 volts is going into it. So it's comparing 0 volts against where the window is. So if you shift the window up, okay, what that does, it moves the window up here, which means that it's comparing against 0 volts, but the blue means that the voltage that you're comparing against is below where the window is. So if I move the window down to the bottom, the color is going to change again and it changes to red. Red means that the voltage you're comparing against is above the window. So I'm going to demonstrate quite a clear application of this, which is rhythmical gates. PAMS here is it has rhythmical LFOs programmed into it, and I'm going to send one of those LFOs into the comparator. There you go. Now you can hear immediately how that sounds. So this is, remember, this is a synced LFO. There you go. So you've got a bit of an offbeat going on there. So that is sounding whenever the voltage of the LFO hits the window that this is comparing against. So I'm going to take the second output. So that second tom sound is sounding when the voltage is not within the window defined. Because this input is normal to the second comparator, I can also use those outputs here to derive separate rhythms. So the settings are more or less the same here, but let's plug them all in and then move them around. There you go, you've got very syncopated pattern there already. And it's akin to like tuning an envelope. You know, you don't think about the time in seconds, the attack and decay portions of an envelope bar. You just tune it to feel and taste, right? It's the same here when you get the rhythms. That's the basics of the comparator section of the module. It gets more interesting when you start working with audio rate, which I'll fuck around with shortly. But while I'm still talking about rhythms, I want to talk about the logic sections at the bottom. So what I've got going on here is two related clocks going into both inputs of the comparator. And I've got these outputs coming out of these logic modules here. I'm going to pause it for a second. These four outputs are listening to both of the comparators. So these outputs here only listen to the respective sides. These inputs only listen to the respective sides. But these outputs are listening to both sides together. AND is an output that fires when both of the comparators are activated, which is to say that whenever their voltage target is compared with the window. If I misalign one of them, you can see that AND turns off. That's because one of the comparators is not active. OR is when both or one of them is active. So you can see if I deactivate the second one, you can see AND switches off and OR stays on. If both of them are deactivated, OR turns off. XOR is if one or the other is on. So if they're both off, that's not going to flash, but if one of them is on, it's going to turn on. Flip-flop, whenever XOR is activated, it toggles the flip-flop, so that turns it on and off basically. So when used like this, I mean, it kind of works a bit like a standard logic module. You can close off the comparator aspect of it, and this is just what you get. Like these size knobs don't do anything. It kind of turns this module into a bit of a Swiss Army knife of logic, really. What I'm doing here is I'm using stages to sequence changes in the size and shift parameters. This means that you can break the repetitiveness of the rhythms. I mean, if I take these out, it's just going to do that forever, which is cool, but you might want to vary it up a bit. Another way to create non-repetitive rhythms would be to not just use a straight LFO source or, you know, clock source, but to have a variable modulation source going into them. So I've got the Maestro here, and this is six channels of modulation, but you can chain it together, so you can like go from a up down triangle to just a ramp to a fall to a down up, high low, random, whatever. So you can just chain these different modulations and it's all going to be in sync with everything else. This should work. Yeah, so now I've got a chain of different modulations going through this. So I mean, that is repetitive, obviously, but it's a longer repeating pattern than it would be if there was no modulation going on, if there's no variability to the modulation. All the principles of, you know, sending the LFOs into it and getting these responses work in audio rate as well. So just by sending audio rate signals into it, you can derive like square waves out of it because of the frequency the gates are opening and closing. On headphones, it sounds pretty cool. So on the right side, you can hear just the triangle wave, and on the left side, you can hear the compared version of that. And if you use a flip-flop out, you get an octave. So yeah, there's a lot of tonal potential to be had with this. So yeah, there's a world of tones to be explored within this module, and obviously you can take all of there's so many outputs that you can use to just drive other modules. Like, let's just take this and fucking trigger that. Why the hell not? Let's get that going. So yeah, so much interesting stuff you can get out of this module. Funky, slippy, skippy, humanized beats, crazy gates, audio rate gates you can send into other modules and oscillators to trigger insane sounds, frequency division, just event creation. Like, one thing I'm quite excited about is to send this thing pitches from a sequencer. You know, you've got eight notes, one of them's an F4 or something. You can tune this to compare against F4, and when that happens, it's going to send out a gate, and then that gate can trigger events like doing something back on the sequencer, opening up a filter via an envelope, triggering an LFO, triggering modulation from Maestro. You know, there's, you can just create these series of events within your patch to keep things moving and shifting around. I highly recommend checking out DivKid's video, and also Euranalogue's own YouTube channel has got a bunch of good examples as well. I'll link those down below.